rahmatullahi wa barakatuhu. Welcome to class 6 students. Students, today we'll be learning a new lesson which is based on a tablecloth. Why do you think the lesson has the title as tablecloth? What is the speciality of the tablecloth? Okay, I'll give you a hint. Now, you all are playing hide and seek at home. And one table in your house is being covered with a cloth, with a big cloth. And you go hide under the table. What is the positivity of hiding under the table? Yes, because the cloth is covering you and hiding you. Right. So, do you think is there something similar to the to this incident? Yes. So, see, let's read what is there. So, this lesson is called as Tabby's Tablecloth. You all have nicknames. Your parents, your brothers, sisters and relatives call you all by your pet names, right? So here also there was a girl called as Tabitha. Her name was Tabitha and she's just a 14 years old girl. And she is a patriotic girl. This means she loves her country very much. She is called by Tabby. Everybody calls her as Tabby. So let's see who has written this lesson. This lesson is written by Louisa May Alcott. So she is an American writer. She's written many stories and novels. And one of her novels, which is called as Little Women, has become very famous. And whichever story she's written speaks about the real life experiences. She speaks about what happens in the life. And moreover, her stories are based on heroism of ordinary people. What do you mean by heroism? This means bravery. She speaks about the bravery of a common man. So this lesson is also based on the courage and bravery of a girl, a patriotic girl. See, as we all had Indian War of Independence, we all fought with the Britishers to get our independence, right? It's the same thing happened around the world to get back their freedom. So there was an American War of Independence. And this war was between Great Britain and the people of 13 British colonies in America. So this war was between British colonies of America and the Great Britain. So what happened here? Independent nation, America was declared as an independent nation in the year 1776. And people living in towns and villages fought as soldiers, helped by others who were young or old to gain their independence. But what could a tablecloth have to do with the revolution? So now, we read that. See, when it was a time of independence, to secure the independence, everyone participated by supporting each other. So here the writer has put up a question mark. How can a tablecloth become a supporting material for us to fight with the enemies? So let's see what is there. And before we learn, I have a question for you all. We all love our country, right? Yes, we are Indians and we do love our country. So similarly, Americans do love their country. China people do love their own country. Everybody loves their own countries. So here, let's see. On the 20th day of March 1775, Tabitha Tarbell, a slender girl of 14, was walking along a country road in Concord, Massachusetts. She had a basket of eggs on her arm. She seemed to be in a great hurry and looked anxiously about her as she went, for those were dangerous times. So now the writer has spoken about the day of March, that is the 20th day of March. It was March 20th, 1775. And since I told you Tabitha was a 14 years old girl, she was also a participant for the freedom struggle for America. So what she did was, she was going and passing on messages to every house telling, enemies will come and attack us anytime. But you can't go shouting because they can come and attack you. And moreover, you do not know which person from your country is supporting your enemy. Right. So what she used to do was, she used to carry basket of eggs in her hand, and in that basket she would write a letter. In that basket she would keep the letter, and on that letter she would place the eggs and start walking to the people, everybody's house, telling this will happen. So we need to be active enough, so when enemies come, we can save ourselves from them. So this is what she was doing. Tabitha, or Tabby, since I told she's called as Tabby, was full of vigor and patriotism. So she was a girl filled with energy and love for the country. She was agitated and angered too by the rumors that the British were coming to Concord. Here, they were coming to destroy the supplies stored there. See, students, everybody has treasures in our house, right? Even one book, our ancestral book, which will be kept at home, in which they have written certain memories of them, we consider it to be as a treasure. Only gold, diamond and other precious stones are not treasure. There are certain things which are considered to be as treasure also, right? Yes. So this girl, though she was, she loved her country, she was disturbed also. Agitated stands for disturbed. And then she was angry with what people were telling. See, when independence struggle was going on, if you watch those freedom struggle videos, you will find that people shouting. When it was Indian independence, we find that our Indians shouting loudly, attack, I mean, and enemies are going to attack us, go save yourselves, right? So those in America, people started spreading rumors, going and giving wrong information to others, telling enemies are going to come and attack Concord. Concord is the name of a place in America. Understood? Yes. In nearly every house, something valuable was hidden. Gunpowder, axes, tents, guns and cartridges. The cannons were hidden in the woods. A guard of 10 men patrolled the town at night. The brave farmers were getting ready for what they felt must come. So now they started preparing for the struggle. See, it is just a year before they got the independence. So here the writer is telling, every house there was something or the other. So what is this something? Every house had gunpowder. That is all the gunpowder, axes, tents, guns and cartridges. These are the weapons used to fight a war. So these things were present in each of the other house. And moreover, guard of 10 men. This means every night 10 men joined together, formed a group and patrolled, went and saved, stood on the borders, protecting the place. The brave farmers were getting ready for what they felt must come. And the farmers also started preparing themselves to face the enemies. There were Tories in the town who gave the enemy all the information they could gather. Now, what do you understand by Tories? You know the word spy? Yes? What is the duty of spy? To have a look on the person whom he's assigned to, right? And you keep spying him so much that you give out the complete detailed history of what he or she would have been done from the starting of the day until the end. So here also in America, there were people who didn't support America. They were supporting Britain. So this girl kept in mind that there are Tories. We call them as Tories. People who do not support their country and support other countries are called as Tories. So she's telling that there were Tories in the town of Conrad. So she made sure that nobody would get to know how they were planning to fight the struggle. So let's see what happens now. Therefore, much caution was necessary in making plans. So whenever they were making plans, they took each and every cautious step to make sure that this person is trustworthy. Yes, I can trust this person. We can make a plan to fight for the freedom. Passwords and secret signals were used. Messages were sent from house to house in all sorts of strange ways. So she's telling, passwords and signals were secret signals. See, those days it was not a technified era. As we live in the era of technology wherein everything can be done with a mobile device, those days there was nothing as such. Everything had to be done verbally and either by the other ways of communication, right? So she's telling, the writer is telling us that they were so cautious that they kept in mind that there was no Tory sitting around them, and they went and gave a message to every family in such different ways that nobody would get to know. Carrying an egg basket and going to your neighbor's house, what will you assume? Yes, she's going to give the eggs to the neighbor. But the actual reason is she's going to pass on the information about the freedom struggle. Understanding?